In this chapter, we are going to be discussing several topics related to acid-base equilibria. This chapter is referred to as chapter 15 for purposes of this class. However, it is still including sections from chapter 14 in the OpenStax book. So we are specifically covering these four sections in this chapter. The main topics we'll be discussing in this chapter are buffers, acid-base titration, pH calculations, and insoluble salts. As always, our resource for materials that I've used in this chapter. And to begin this chapter, we discuss the concept of writing neutralization reactions, writing equations for these. And it's helpful to review how we write the molecular ionic and net ionic equations, because as we go through the chapter, most of our reactions are going to be acid-base reactions. So it's very helpful to know and remind ourselves how to write these, and particularly how to distinguish between these three types of equations. For our first example, we have HCl, which of course we know is a strong acid. We have NaOH, which we know is a strong base. And of course, we should be able to predict that our products here are going to be the salt of sodium chloride and water. This equation is already balanced in a one-to-one ratio, so this is our molecular equation. Remember that for ionic equations, we simply take substances that are aqueous and divide them into their dissociated ions. The purpose of writing an ionic equation is to show what breaks apart as ions in water versus what stays together. So remember that in an ionic equation, all of your solids, liquids, and gases are going to stay together, like water, for example. So for our ionic equation, of course, hydrochloric acid will dissociate completely because it's a strong acid. Sodium hydroxide will completely dissociate because it's a strong base. On the product side, sodium chloride will also completely dissociate because it's a soluble salt, and then water will stay together. For our next step, we describe how we go from the ionic equation to the net ionic. The key thing to recognize here is that we cross out any of our spectator ions. Remember from chapter 14 when we were describing salts that any ion that comes from a strong acid or a strong base will always be a neutral spectator. So notice chloride is the same form on both sides, it will cancel. Sodium is also the same form on both sides, it will also cancel. They're the same form and the same numbers, right? So I have one sodium, so it completely cancels. What we're left with at the end of canceling our spectator ions is our net ionic equation. So the net reaction that is taking place here is the reaction between the hydrogen ion and the hydroxide ion to form water. Which, again, if you remember in chapter 14, we technically described as setting up equilibrium. However, that equilibrium is so favored toward water that we can just write a one-direction arrow here. For equation number two, we're going to go through the same steps. However, now we have a slightly different substance. We are now working with hydrofluoric acid, which we should recognize as a weak acid. To predict products from our molecular equation, we go through the same process. This is still a double replacement reaction. So there, our salt is going to be sodium fluoride. We still form water, and everything is still in a one-to-one ratio. However, the difference here is our hint question about what happens to HF in solution. Since we know that hydrofluoric acid is weak, we know that it won't dissociate completely. And so when we go to write our ionic equation, we are actually going to leave hydrofluoric acid together as an intact molecule. Because it dissociates to such a small extent, I cannot show it as a dissociated acid. That is one difference between first semester general chemistry and this semester. In first semester, it was explained that everything that's aqueous will break apart, but that depends on the strength of what we're talking about. So anything weak will actually stay together in solution. We wouldn't show it dissociated in water. To get to our net ionic equation, we still go through the same steps. We still need to cancel out our spectator ions. Notice here that the sodium ion is the only spectator. And so our net ionic equation is actually going to show the reaction between hydrofluoric acid and a hydroxide ion. Notice here at the end of our net ionic equation that it is still balanced. We balance for atoms and charges. So we have two hydrogens, one fluorine, one oxygen. On the product side, we have two hydrogens, one oxygen, one fluorine. Notice our charges also balance. On the reactant side, we have a total of a negative one. Remember that hydrofluoric acid is a neutral molecule, so no net charge there. On the product side, we have the negative one charge from our fluoride ion. And so we are balanced for atoms and for charges. This is a good stopping point for our introduction. On our next video, we will start to introduce the concept of a buffer solution and how it is made.